Welcome to Undisputed. We are live from Los Angeles. I'm Jenny Taft here with Skip Bayless and Shannon Sharp. How are we doing today, guys?
We're good, doing good. TNT looked good last night, didn't
Skip? Is that all we're going to talk about?
The Fakers were at it again last night, weren't they?
Oh, get well soon, Lagans. We need you. Please come help save us.
Help is on the way.
Is it?
Friday night? Is that your inside info? We got Lagan back on Friday night?
Maybe. Maybe.
Help is on the way. I do like when you say it like that.
Might tease you a little longer, make you wait till Sunday.
Good.
Okay.
I can't wait.
Well, LeBron is still not there, and that means the Lakers right now, well, they're missing him a little bit. The LeBron-less Lakers were handed a 109-102 loss last night to the defending champion Bucks. Giannis scored 47 points while Anthony Davis and Russell Westbrook were held to 37 points combined. King James could reportedly return tomorrow against the Celtics, which is good since the team is 3-5 since he's been out with that abdominal injury. So, Shannon, why haven't the Lakers been able to win without LeBron?
I got two reasons. The first reason, Skip, because nobody's had a greater impact on winning than one LeBron James. In the history of basketball, we've seen teams. We saw the Chicago Bulls without Michael Jordan become a bad Hugh Hollins call away from advancing to the Eastern Conference Finals. We see LeBron James leave Cleveland, and they're in the lottery getting the top one or two pick for the entire time that he's in Miami. We see him leave Miami, and we see what happened to them. We see when he's with the Lakers, they're a top five team when he plays. They're a bottom five when he isn't.
Wait a second. LeBron has six losses in the finals. That same guy, is that what we're talking about?
I would just say that again. He has six losses where?
In the finals,
so
including getting swept by the San Antonio Spurs.
How do you get to the finals?
How do you get swept by the Spurs when you are the best player on the planet?
Well, I'm just asking. I'm just. I want to make sure we're talking about the same
so
guy.
So what do you have to do in the regular season to get to the finals? Since you interrupted, go ahead.
You cakewalk through the East.
Oh, now it's a cakewalk. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So how did he get to the finals in the West? Oh, it's always an excuse. Oh, it was a pandemic.
Bubble.
Gotcha. Yeah. The second reason is because if Anthony Davis is a top 10 player when LeBron is there, that is good enough to win you a lot of games, possibly get you to the finals, maybe win the finals. When LeBron isn't there, Anthony Davis needs to be a top five player, not just a top five talent. And far too many times we see games like last night, 18-9, 22-8 against Minnesota, 20-6 and gets ejected against Chicago. We don't see enough games like we saw against Charlotte. 32-12 against San Antonio, 34-15. Remember last year, he dominated in the regular season. He dominated DeAndre Ayton. We saw him put up that monster game against Nikola Jokic against Denver. We don't see enough of those games. You see the difference? The difference between Anthony Davis and Giannis Antetokounmpo is one thing, mindset. Giannis says, I'm going to the rim, come hell or high water. He's going to the rim. You can't tell me, nobody can tell me that Giannis is a more skilled, a more talented player than Anthony Davis. He doesn't shoot the three. He turned himself into a shot. Was shooting the three good last night, Skip. Shot the free throw pretty good last night, Skip. But you go 18-20.
Talking about Russ, right?
No, I'm talking about Giannis.
Oh, Giannis. I'm sorry. I thought you went to Russ.
No, I'm saying you can't tell
me. No, he did. He had a huge. He scored 47 points.
That's my point. I'm saying you can't tell me Anthony Davis shouldn't be able to do that.
It's his mindset. I totally agree.
So far too many times we talk about Anthony Davis as a top five talent, but he doesn't play like that.
Yep.
And when you have LeBron, Skip, you can be a top 10 player. And with LeBron being as great as he is, you can win games.
Mm-hmm.
But when you remove one of those, that top five talent needs to be a top five player. And far too many times, we don't see Anthony Davis do that. Shaq would go out. Kobe being Kobe would be a top five player. They would win games. Vice versa. We don't see that enough from Anthony Davis.
Yep.
We saw what he was doing. I need that Anthony Davis.
Mm-hmm.
That was in New Orleans. And everybody's talking about he's this, he's that. He's giving you 28-12 on a nightly basis. I need to see that AD more times than not when LeBron is not there. Then you can win these games. Skip, this is unacceptable. 18-19. You can't have Giannis outscore your two superstars by himself. That cannot happen.
True.
And far too many times we're seeing this happen where the opposing team's best player outdoes AD.
Yep.
Well, when LeBron leaves, the whole thing about getting AD skipped was the transition. Mm. LeBron is getting on up there in age. You're 17, you're 18, you're 19, you're 20. Okay, this is AD's opportunity. It says, okay, we're in good hands. I don't see that enough, Skip. Mm. And that's the problem. AD is a top 10 player that has top five talent. But when you remove one LeBron James, mm-hmm. he doesn't play like a top five player.
Yep.
And that's what needs to happen when LeBron isn't there. So, yes, we can't minimize LeBron's impact because we've seen it wherever he's gone, from Cleveland to Miami, from Miami back to Cleveland, Cleveland to L.A. We okay. see a dip when he's not there or when he leaves. But AD, you got to be that guy. Mm. And I don't see you being that guy nearly enough when LeBron isn't there.
I agree. So I'm going to go slightly bigger picture to start with. And
agree with something I said?
I thought you made some actually shockingly valid points. I don't know what got into you. I don't know what you had for breakfast, but.
Le Portier.
Did you? Okay.
Don't tell nobody those things.
Right.
Between me
okay,
and you.
Good. Big picture. The biggest surprise of the NBA season so far to me, I'll go all the way to the biggest shock, is that your Lakers are only 8-8 after playing 12 of their first 16 games at home.
Easy schedule says.
At home. And I realize your man, LeBron, has played only 6 of those 16, and they went 4-2 in those games. But still, I look at this box score this morning. At Bucks, remember, Bucks for only the
third—they're struggling too.
Only the third time all year they had their quote-unquote big three right. together last night because Middleton came off the COVID list and Drew Holiday is still banged up, but he's trying to go. And obviously, Giannis went and went and went last night.
Yes,
for 47 points, his biggest showing since the finals.
Mm-hmm.
Because they have struggled all year. And remember, they do not have Brooke Lopez and they do not yet have DiVincenzo back.
Mm-hmm.
From his ankle injury, and so they're struggling because they can't find themselves because right. they just haven't been whole yet.
Correct.
Okay, so we get all that. But I'm looking at this box score, and I'm saying, okay, wait a second. Russell Westbrook is a slam dunk first ballot Hall of Famer.
Mm-hmm.
Anthony Davis is a no ballot Hall of Famer. He will be whisked in when it's finally over.
Skip, the man made the top 75 of all time.
I got it. And right now, I think most people would rank him probably top five, at least top seven or eight players in the league. I'm going to go top five. Most GMs, if you took a poll, they would put him in the top five.
I think they give him top 10. I don't know if they're going to give him top five with the way
know.
He played this
okay,
year.
But
he's a top 10 player.
Okay, going into this year, they would have put him in the top five.
How
right?
about this? He's a top 10 player with top five talent.
Okay. Carmelo has had a rebirth at Staples, especially at home as opposed to on the road,
mm-hmm.
but a rebirth as a Laker, and he is another slam dunk right. Hall of Famer, right? And then down on the bench, I will not be shocked if Rondo makes the Hall of Fame. And I'm pretty sure Dwight will, and you're a bigger Dwight fan than I
yes.
am. But you just think he belongs in the Hall of Fame
yeah.
because you thought he belonged in the top 75 of all
he
time.
He absolutely belonged.
Okay, so he barely played last night. Rondo played a little and did a lot, actually, mm-hmm. in the little that he played.
Right.
But my point is, I just gave you star-studded. Now I'm going to get to the guts of my point. The crux of my point is LeBron James, I always say highest IQ in basketball, handpicked Anthony Davis.
Mm-hmm.
Did he not?
Yeah.
And he moved heaven and clutch sports earth to maneuver him mm-hmm. out of New Orleans to get him to Los Angeles. He's flawed, but LeBron wanted him. So you got to chalk it up. LeBron went out of his way. He basically gave up that whole first year because it was just a nightmare disaster in the mm-hmm. locker room because it was clear for about, didn't it go on like 6 months
right.
of we're going to get AD.
Right.
LeBron wants to trade you. Remember that?
Yeah.
Okay. To Brandon
Ingram. All the way up to the trade
okay.
deadline.
All right. So it was all about getting AD.
Mm-hmm.
And then as you have acknowledged and disavowed 20 times on this show, LeBron handpicked Russell Westbrook over Buddy Hield. Am I right?
Yeah.
Okay, so he wanted Russ, and he wanted AD, and those are the two biggest reasons that they're 8-8. So LeBron has to have some GM culpability
oh, yeah.
for this. Just some, mm-hmm. because, again, I think he operates as the de facto GM. I think he basically is at least he and Rob Pelinka work together, and I think LeBron has to at least sign off on everything
well,
that's going to happen.
Skip, you know how this thing works. You covered basketball. You know when you got that type, level of superstar player, the GM, run things by him. So what do you think about this player? Would you be in, would you like to play with him if we can get this guy?
I got it. So these are LeBron's guys. And the whole idea was he's in year 19. So you need two fallbacks. You need two guys who are still, one is just barely entered his prime, and right. the other guy's still at the end of his prime in Russ.
Right.
And you need those two because he's, LeBron's probably, I'm going to knock on wood before I say this, but in year 19, with that high mileage, he's played the third most minutes in the history of basketball. Right. He's probably going to have a nick and a knack and a nick and a knack. Right. He's going to have an ab.